So after waiting a long hours for at the 2 minutes, it was hang. So Vishwamite, just what you have to do is the power of this Vishwamite by clicking on this power off, and what you have to do is you need to start again. After powering off this, just click on start Vishwamite completely. You need to power off. Then what you have to do is you need to press immediately F8 to boot the menu. So press F8 to boot from the menu, and after that, so after tapping F8, so we came to the boot menu. So here you can see we need to select here our hard disk which I have given untitled the name of during the installations. And now you can see if you press enter here, it will be go for the normal installation. If you type minus V, that will be diagnostic center will be come up. If you type the question mark, you will get help center. So now I'm going to go to this hard disk, and there I need to type -S -V and give -N. You need to press enter here. So after that typing, you need to wait for this command prompt. You will come. This is booting in a save mode. So you need to be wait here. And now finally we came to the save mode command. So here we need to type this one. So you can see on the screen. You need to type the root device like /sb. So you can see on the screen to the top of here. Let me show you. So this one is to mount the root device, read hyphen write. So we need to type the both the command, just give /sb and then give fsck ck give space hyphen f5. So after typing that, you need to press enter here. So after that it's going to be check all those things. Now after typing, that has been completed. Now I'm going to type /sbin give /, and to type mount and -uw give space /. So you need to press enter here. So that's going to be link. So after that command, when you type this /bin/mount, it will be linked. All those things, it will be come with the installation directories and remove the unwanted file system. Everything is going to be come with here. That will take your 10 minutes more. So now I'm going to here typing here. So I'm going to enter into the directory, type cd/.o type install sandbox path. After that, what you have to do is you need to type the script here, sicrpt script. So press enter here, and now you need to type ls here. So all this is the packages you can see. This is your update packages are showing in this macOS. So what you have to do is we need to go to the inside the folder of this one package, type cd, and need to type hackintosh zone, and then give a tab to get a full command. Then you need to type here post installation post type port, then press a tab to get a full command, or else you can see tab tell po, press a tab to get ust. Need to type here, and then you will need to type here script. So you can find here in this one you need to find hackintosh dot zone dot after that you need to search for the wait, I'm going to show you the file name I'm missing. Just type capital zero zone, then you need to give capital P, press tab key to get a full command PST post script. So you need to press enter here. After that you need to type /, you need to type PST port install, press enter. So now it's going to be installed in a save mode. Now we'll come up with a screen with a login screen. You need to wait here for a few minutes. After that our message will become on the login screen. So still is running, showing some of the warnings is coming. So you need to ignore all those warnings and errors during this message. Now that has been complete. Now what I have to do is we need to exit here. Type ext exit here, press enter. Now we'll come with the boot menu will come here macOS. So wait for your 2 minutes here. you will come up, there's no such file or directory will come up. Like you need to ignore whatever the no such or file errors and warnings errors, just ignore that one. Waiting for DSMOS. Now what can I say? Still coming out. That has been completed. So DSMOS has been arrived. Now sir, that has been completed. Now I'm going to start. We do not do anything, just we need to keep watching here on a screen. It will come up, it will be come with a welcome screen, will come here. So finally we came to welcome screen. On screen you can see, so just we need to select here language, here time zone. I'm going to select here India here by default. Let's see. So just what you have to do is just go for this. You need to click on continue, selecting your time zone. After that you need to click on continue, and you can see you need to select your keyboard language here. Select your which language you suitable, you need to select your that one. So the transfer for this information on this Mac, you can see, do you want to transfer this disk, whatever. If you want to select the first option, second, I do not want to transfer the information, I am select, click on continue. Then I do not want to sign in on the cloud, Apple ID, don't have any ID. If you want to create, you can create it. Then you need to click on continue, then skip this one. After that, you need to accept the license agreement here, click on agree, then click on agree again. After that, will come with a computer account. We need to create a computer account to login with this username and the password. Here I have been created an account for the computer, given the full name and the account name, the password I have given, and then click on continue. So if you want to have a diagnostic and uses means, you can check. I'm going to uncheck this option and click on continue, and it's going to set up in our Mac. So finally we log in here with the Mac OS. You so might, so you can see the latest version of this have been installed. And scroll down, see, will come up here. So you can see here right side also, you show my zone, Hackintosh. Go for the help, click on the help, and then get a Mac help. So here you can see on the settings, phone memory, everything is there. We'll check the latest. So my friend, internet also working in that one, Hackintosh. Now I'm going to show you how to make a full screen also. So my friend, you can see my OS X Yoso Meet is the version, you can see on 10.10 version, Mac summer 2009, processor and memory, RAM, and the name for the installation I have given, title, the display, graphic 3 MB, serial number, you can see on display, storage, everything you can see on my screen. This is your so my friend, to make a full screen here resolution, first of all I'm going to edit the configuration file in Yosemite MacOS. To for that one, first of all you need to click a finder, you need to go to the preference here, preference. In that you need to check all those option boxes, everything, whatever find you need to check. You need to click on slide bar, there you need to check all the boxes. After checking the box, just close this one, and you need to come down, scroll down, and you need to click on finder here. After clicking on the finder, you need to click on Mac OS cloud device. You need to see on the device, there you will find your hard disk about the name of installation. There you need to click untitled, that means whatever the name you have given for this installation name, I have given untitled, that's why. So you need to double click on this one, untitled, and there you need to click on extra folder. You will find, you search for the folder, you need to open the extra folder with the name. Just open the extra folder and you need to open the file. org.camelon.bluebootplaylist. So you need to open this file. For opening this, right click and you need to go to edit with text, edit the file. And what you have to do is you need to in between the district and slash district, you need to give your screen resolution size. For that one, just press enter here, press space bar, and you need to give greater than symbol. Again you need to type key here. After that, close this one and give a graphics, and then give a graphics mode, and then close the slash with a key. Okay, then close the bracket here. We interpret, press enter again, and you need to come here on the line, press greater than symbol. You need to type string, string, then you need to close this one with a bracket. Okay, after that you need to type the screen resolution, that is 1920, which is I'm giving into 1080 into 32, that is 32 or 64 bit you can give here. So after that you need to give a bracket slash give string string, you need to give close this one. So after this, giving this points, you need to add these 2 points, graphic mode and the strings. After adding this in between the districts and slash district between district, you need to save this file. To save, either you can press Ctrl S or you can save this file from direct. So my friend, you can give screen resolution whatever you want to give. Whichever your resolution you want to fit, you can give it. I am giving 1920. Either you can give in place of 1920, you can give 1600 into 1200 or 1400 into 32. You can give any resolution you want to give. Just saving this file and to close this one. And what you have to do is you need to shut down this one, Macintosh. Just close this one and power up this one. So now we have to make a small changes in the Windows also. For that one, you need to press start. First of all, you need to log in with the administrator here. After login, you need to click on start, and you need to type here cmd. So you need to right click on cmd, run as administrator. And after that, what you have to do is, now you need to open your C drive. Just click on C drive, go to the programs file, search where you have downloaded the virtual box. So you need to search for the Oracle here, and here is my virtual box. So what you have to do is, you need to copy this link, or else you need to drag the link here. So how you can drag the link here, first select this option, and so either you can copy this link, just Control C copy, and come to your command prompt, paste it here. You need to press enter here. While pasting, we get an internal error command not found, means just type cd and give this space and paste the command here. Press enter. Now what I have to do is open this one. You need to copy this link and you need to paste this hole in your virtual box. Here is the resolution which I have given in my macOS. The same resolution you need to give here also. You can also change the resolution, like in place of 1920 into etc, you can give 600, 900, also 32. But you need to change, give the changes there also in macOS also. Resolution you need to change there. So whatever the resolution you need to you are fitting, you need to give the same resolution there also, here also. Now here as we need to change here, we need to give the name of virtual machine. For that one, you need to open your virtual box, and you need to find your macOS Yosemite. Click on settings, just copy this name here which you have given the name, and then minimize this one, then come here and remove the name of virtual machine, place paste this name. After that, you need to copy this whole line and copy this one line, and come here and right click and paste this one, press enter. So after this complete successful, what you have to do is you need to open your virtual box and click on start again. Now it will come with a full screen resolution. So my friend, you can see this is my Macintosh. So I'm making changes in the screen resolution. You can see it is working fine. It's coming the full screen also here. When I put a small screen, it's coming full screen. So you can see it's logging, so it's booting. So this is how you can make a full screen resolution. Finally, we need to log in here with the username we created, and you can see shutdown login. Just enter the password here, press enter here. So my friend, thank you for watching my IT Cloud Net video on macOS Shushamite. So if you have any problem, if you get any problem, you can comment below to my video. Thank you for watching IT Cloud Net. Please subscribe to Cloud Net channel.